We go count down for the live. Y'all ready? Huh? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
In 5, 4, 3, 2, and
so hot air, hot air. So hot air. So hot air.
Good theme song.
It is.
It's a good theme song.
It's hot. I was like,
hey, we are here. The truck cast has begun.
Yes, sir.
What's going on? It's your baby man, Humpy.
It's your boy, DB.
And this is the truck cast.
Yes, sir.
And you know what we do here.
What we do?
We talk about relationships.
We talk about relationships.
We talk about love.
Love.
Dating issues.
Dating.
Marriage.
Like, then you put a ring on it. Okay, keep going.
Okay. And we talk about how to find love and stay together longer than 60 days.
Longer than 60 days?
Longer than 60 days.
That's a long ass time.
What do you guys think of that?
It's a long time.
Hold on. What did you say? That's a long time.
In these days.
Wow. In 2020, it's a long time.
That's a long time.
So if you like a person within 60, go ahead and...
Get married.
Then promise ring or something, right?
Mm-hmm. It's 60 days.
Yes. Hey, I'm trying to tell you it means something. Hey, shout out to everybody that's watching us tonight. Taco Tuesday.
Yes, sir.
Hey, it's been a while.
We ain't getting any Taco Tuesday. Man,
and them tacos. Hey, you.
We ate 5114 Christian tailgate.
Hey, you seen I had them tacos. I'm like, man, I'm out. Give me some tacos. You know, I ain't had tacos in forever.
Tacos, man.
Hey, make sure you guys continue to support us. We're on Spotify, SoundCloud,
iHeartRadio.
Oh, we are. iHeartRadio. We're on
YouTube,
Facebook,
Tumblr.
Tumblr. You know Tumblr's back.
And you said SoundCloud? You said SoundCloud.
SoundCloud, yeah. Twitter. Make sure you guys follow us on Libsyn.com.
Mm-hmm.
Type up The Truck Cast, TheTruckCast. Mm-hmm. It'll take you right there for everything you need to know about Humvee.
And your boy DB.
It's going down in a major way. We're on all streaming platforms.
Yes, sir.
It's going down. As you can see, we have two guests in the back of the truck tonight.
Mm.
Two guests in the back of the truck tonight.
Yeah.
It's going down in a major way.
Yes, sir.
You know, this young lady. I mean, I'm going to just let her introduce herself. You know what I'm saying? I'll let you guys introduce yourselves. Go ahead. Go for it.
Well, I am Holly Heat. Most people know me as Holly Heat.
Holly!
What up?
The Holly Heat on Instagram. Holly Heat on Facebook. And y'all don't need to know about my Snapchat. No. Kidding.
Oh, we on Snapchat too.
I am a sports personality. Yeah. A female sports personality. And a health and wellness entrepreneur. So that's kind of my...
That's your shtick.
You?
And then wrong with that?
Daniel.
What up, three?
I'm a producer, artist, and designer. This is my clothing line, Blackbird Gold.
Okay.
Blackbird Gold?
Yeah.
You got in 5X?
Blackbird Gold. You know what? I can make this specially
for
you.
That's what I'm talking about. You
know? I hear rocking Blackbird Gold, baby.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm talking about.
Ready.
Black on.
We are also, we are castmates on a Houston-based reality show called Hustle and Heartbreaks Houston.
Yep. Hustle and Heartbreaks.
Hustle and Heartbreaks.
That's almost, that's like on y'all relationship thing.
Yeah,
it is.
You know, we hustle and we do the relationship.
Yeah.
Holla at us, producer. Holla at us.
Exactly.
That's it right there.
Hey,
man. I know Holly Heat.
Mm-hmm.
Three.
Yeah.
I guess we can get right. So, what about
wait,
a PSA?
Wait, do we take a toast or anything prior to the
end?
I think we need to take a toast. I feel like
the truck cast for providing us
with
this.
Taco Tuesday.
Taco Tuesday.
Toasted with plastic cups. Them the best ones, baby. I'm telling you. If it ain't red, they plastic and they all clear. Them the best nights. I'm telling you.
This sweet tea is good.
Yeah, this sweet tea.
This sweet tea is awesome.
Sweet tea, delicious. Delicious.
What,
sweet tea named Crown. Anyway,
hey, should we do a PSA now?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, since we got the Heat and the three in the building, three Heats, you know what I'm saying? Like the Heatles in the building, you know what I'm saying? We just need one more person.
Hey. But anyway,
go ahead. If you got anything on your chest, anything that's on your mind that you want to get off.
Ladies first.
Ladies first.
I was going to say ladies first.
Ladies first. So anything that you want to talk about, the chicken sandwich, you want to talk about how you was sitting at the soul food restaurant, and this guy was sucking on some goddamn neck bones, some goddamn hard, whatever you want to talk
glasses
about.
Glasses low.
Go ahead and get it off your chest.
I was doing too much.
Yeah, too much.
Right. You almost made me have a second PSA there. About when you started talking about the neck bones, I was almost about to say, as a white person, we do season our food sometimes.
I've never had
we
white
do season
bones.
Our food sometimes.
And I don't...
But that was not going to be my PSA.
Okay.
So I felt compelled to say something.
Okay. Stand up for your people, Hollywood. Ain't nothing wrong with that, Mama.
White lives matter.
Look, we don't have much culture, but we do know how to use a little bit of salt.
A little bit of salt. You
know?
A little bit.
I got high blood pressure, so trust me, I know how to use salt.
Okay. Don't saturate.
But no, my PSA is just because a woman is a fan. Mm-hmm. Of somebody in sports, whether it be basketball player, football player,
hockey
boxer,
player.
Hockey, baseball player,
right.
Tennis player,
right.
Does not mean that she is attracted to him or she has romantic feelings to him. This is the biggest thing that I get.
Biggest misnomer, huh?
Yes.
Hmm.
Being a Dwayne Wade fan.
On IG.
See? There you go. Toxic masculinity. But anyway, that's for another day.
Toxic? Hold on.
Holly brought the heat.
Hold on. PSA.
It's your PSA. Go
my
ahead.
PSA.
I bet. I'm sorry.
Toxic.
I am a Dwayne Wade fan
because
I admire his talents on the court. And during those four quarters is what I look at him for.
Okay.
Definitely.
It is not any romantic feelings, no attraction.
Gotcha.
None of those type of things. So, when a woman is a fan, it does not necessarily mean that she is sexually or romantically attracted to a man.
I heard it.
And they would never ask a man if he was romantically or sexually attracted to his favorite player. Am I right or wrong?
I don't know. Well, that sounds like a good question to pose.
Who's
though?
Your favorite player?
I don't have one.
Oh, okay. Who's your favorite athlete?
I mean, he retired already.
Yeah, that's
Jerry Rice. But who's your favorite player?
I am Jerry Rice, but I am not sexually attracted to him.
Exactly. Who's your favorite athlete?
I don't have a favorite athlete.
Yeah,
anyway,
I don't. Yeah.
If you pull men, a lot of men are maybe Michael Jordan fans. They're,
yeah, of course.
You
MJ,
know,
I can throw that
Tom Brady, something. Right. You don't talk to them and ask them, are they romantically attracted to that athlete, right? Right or wrong?
Way to go, Holly.
Okay.
She's bringing the heat.
Okay.
All I'm saying is that
it's extremely sexist to believe that just because a woman is a fan of sports that she has to have some kind of sexual attraction to whoever she's a fan of.
It does.
Well, on
sense.
That note,
that's
I have
PSA.
A PSA.
Okay.
On that note, I have a PSA. Just because a nigga is giving you a compliment, it does not mean that we trying to get with you.
Thank you!
I just think you look lovely tonight or today or whatever. You have
right.
a nice figure, you know, you look good, you know, and that's it. It don't mean like
keep it moving.
I'm trying to, and keep it moving. Like, don't give me the attitude. Why you gotta give me the attitude? Like, you know. Just
you know what, three? I kind of have to disagree with you on that, brother, because you know what? I'm not saying you wrong, because everybody is entitled to their opinion.
Yeah,
and my opinion is very, very educated, because you know why? This is my show. Anyway, so, but I'm going to tell you like this. My whole thing is, I really do feel like when a guy is giving a woman a compliment, he be like, hey, I like your hair. He's saying, want some dick? He's saying, you sure do smell good. Want some dick? I mean, that makes sense too.
But my thing is like, don't give the attitude.
Okay.
It's the big attitude.
Just accept the compliment.
Just accept the compliment.
And don't, compliment. If I didn't come at you with any extra,
exactly.
Just say thank you. But if I be like, okay, give what's a compliment you might have told that young lady that she
might. You know what? Yo, you looking really good tonight. You know?
Right.
Whatever, nigga. Whatever. I'm like, whoa.
What? You know what? I hope you stomp your goddamn toe when you get
home. Bow.
How about that?
Bow. Exactly.
You know, I hope your hot water heater go out tonight. How about that?
That's all I'm saying. PSA.
Hey, I like that PSA. Holly Heat and Three. Thank you guys so
appreciate
much.
Appreciate you, man. That was some good PS.
I feel better.
I'm glad you guys got it out.
I feel drastically better now.
Get it off your chest, man.
Thank you.
Definitely.
You have to get it off your chest because sometimes you hold that energy in and it becomes stressful.
And you end up popping somebody in the face that you ain't want.
You got to let it off on the compliment that I just gave. My bad.
That makes sense. Hey, shout out to everybody that's tuned in. YouTube Live, Facebook Live, Holly Heat, and Three.
Yes, sir.
The producer, right?
Yeah.
He about to drop us that truck cast intro.
Hey. There it is.
So many ideas. It's the tea.
I love the tea.
Yes, the tea.
All right. You guys know what time it is. Truck Fishing.
Truck Fishing time. This is what we do. We have our truck casters, which is our viewers, our fans. Mm-hmm. All the lovely, all six of y'all watching right now. People out here entertained by the truck cast. We get so many views, over 1,500 views a day. And if you want some of the best advice, people email us at truckcast2018@gmail.com and get some of the best advice you can ever get. So this is not another Truck Fishing where you come to us and we give you maybe the world-class advice. Great sound.
From two people that's been in the game and been doing our thing in relationships dating for a mighty long time. All right, you guys ready for it?
Let's get it.
All right, here we go. Hey, Humvee and DB.
What up?
I'm going through it right now. I have been single for about 8 months now, and I started to make friends with a woman at work.
Work life?
Yeah, it started off real innocent with water cooler talk here and there.
Be a woman.
And then one day, she asked me to go out to lunch. During lunch, she spilled the beans to me about her marriage and how it was going nowhere real fast. She said all he cares about is his job and doesn't take care of home, which means her family, which means her and her family. This went on and on so long that we didn't even finish our lunch. At the end of the day, we ended up walking to the parking lot together, and there she began to cry on my shoulder. So I consoled her and gave her a hug. I honestly felt bad for her. Me being a man with a beautiful woman crying on my shoulder, I felt compelled to do something. But why are y'all laughing? But I didn't know what to do because she is married and I didn't want to get caught up in her personal affairs. But she put it on when she rose her head up and kissed me.
Oh, no.
I was shocked at first and so was she. We looked at each other for a moment, then we kissed again. This time our tongues got thrown into the mix. I think we at least did about 2 minutes of kissing in the parking lot.
They made out.
Yeah, they made out. That's makeout stuff right there. Afterwards, we left, and on the way to the house, she called me and told me that she really enjoyed the kissing session and told me that her husband is going out of town and wants us to plan an evening together one day for the weekend. We have been spending the past 2 weeks at work, at lunch, in the parking lot, and on the phone so much so that everyone at work is calling her my work wife.
Work wife!
And her my work husband.
Oh, wow.
Our special day is approaching, and she has sent me pics of her in lingerie and told me she is ready special for a day. Good time.
What the hell is a special day?
I know.
But in the back of my mind, I'm like, what am I doing? I don't want to mess with a married woman. But on the other hand, she is fine as hell, and those pics she sends me and our conversations make me think that we're in a relationship.
Is he single?
I mean, he didn't say anything. Mm-hmm. All right, so what's up, y'all? I need your help. Do I cut it off or do I go for it? Great show, guys. Thanks for the outlet. Signed, H.
H. For hell yeah, you do that shit, bro. I say, is she fine as hell, bro? Why not, man? I mean, shit, you single, sound like you single. You ain't saying nothing about your gal. I mean, whoever is at home must not be treating her right. Let's let the guest talk. I'm sorry.
Holly Heat, Three, what do we think?
First of all, your letter sound like you and your feelings. I really think you should probably leave that alone, bro, until they get there. Because the only thing she's doing is reliving all the shit that she want to do with her husband. Mm. As soon as her husband come back with like I'm sorry and everything like that, you gonna be left out of cold because she really want. She got married for a reason, bro.
I like that.
You know what I'm saying?
I like that.
And as soon as she get on back with that, after you got on your feelings, because you already feel like you in a relationship with her, bro. Oh man,
he did say that.
As soon as you there. You know, so you fragile right now.
Right.
You know, and if he you sprung. Really, if you sprung, man, and if you really don't want nobody really messing with you like that, messing with your heart like you breathing real hard.
Right. What's going on, yo? What's
going on my car?
Your turn.
Well, go ahead.
Somebody like, got some feelings going on.
Like
yeah.
A true man, he probably omitted the fact that he's probably in a whole relationship.
Whoa.
He's probably in a whole relationship.
Hold on, let's talk about what's this in the letter. He didn't say that. Let's talk about
thank it. Thank you.
You know what?
Thank you, three.
He did not say that.
Exactly. So
he did not say that. Just like when maybe I meet men, they don't disclose that they are in a relationship. Or
this is about age.
Never
this is about age.
Okay.
You acting like Holly Cole right now.
No type of heat coming from this one.
Holly Cole. Lost all the damn heat.
So you feel like he's in one himself.
He might be in one. Okay. Let's just say he's not in a relationship.
Okay.
At the end of the day.
Okay.
She's in a marriage. Gone and just.
That's true.
I mean, although people are crazy these days. I will say people are crazy these days.
Mm-hmm.
But chances are you could probably just hit it and quit it.
That's the heat.
But they work.
She
but
really
they work together, though.
They do work together. She needs a fix.
Yeah, she needs a fix.
That's she it. Needs to feel that's sexy
it.
Again.
And people right. can still exactly. That's what it is. Okay, gotcha.
She just need to feel
she
that
need to feel
again.
Wanted. Mm-hmm. She want to feel sexy. She want to feel that, like, passion.
So if you about that life, H,
yeah.
if you about that life and you ain't really in your feelings, then you could. You could hit it, quit it, get your rocks off, and keep it moving.
I think yeah.
Now, while I would not condone that, because I feel like you shouldn't be in any relationship that you would want to cheat on somebody with, which probably why I'm single.
Dang.
But, I'm saying.
You hear that, fellas?
She using you, bitch.
Hey, look, she says she's single. Don't be my goddamn inbox.
No.
Trying to,
definitely,
hey, man, what's up with the heat?
Single.
I'm trying to water down the heat. Look, let me do that shit,
all,
man.
All I'm saying
I got the marshmallow for the heat.
Marshmallows for the heat.
And
wow.
Go ahead,
wait,
that was corny, sorry.
I've never heard that.
Hey, heat, you need some marshmallows?
That was a little.
Ready to go camping, huh?
Heat, can I put the chicken on your fry?
What?
Man,
you know how they be saying.
Hey, you digging yourself a deeper hole. Go ahead.
I don't say that.
Get on out of there.
Back to H.
No. H. Listen.
His name Harm. Henry.
He probably just hit it and quit it.
Hunter.
Like, don't get your feelings in it. I know.
I think it's
three thinks he's in his feelings.
I think he is, though.
Hey, man,
I didn't think about that, though.
Hey, Holcomb, just get out your feelings. You know what I'm saying?
You can't call that man that, bro.
Hey, you know what? My bad, A.
Oh, that's so messed
up. You gave
up.
Us an A, so you let us just have our way.
Right,
our
right. right.
You know, but, sense. Man, you know, you don't want to get in your feelings too much with that, man, because she's already, she's tied out, you're tied in, you know, you don't want to do that. Unless you just want to get your rock, but I don't get that from you, Agent.
Here's what I think. It depends on what kind of okay, this is, okay, so she works.
Because you're not in a relationship.
Okay, right. Well,
they
she
both
can,
work.
She could maybe do okay independently, but if it was a woman that don't work, she not finna leave her husband.
Okay.
Yeah.
She works. She got to work her husband.
But if
so.
she works, then work. She might be able to live
independently. But think about this, y'all.
Might
be
this. Willing to leave her husband.
Think about this. A woman that's willing to leave her husband, is that somebody you really want to get your relationship with?
Exactly.
That's why you hit it and quit it.
That's why you hit
give
it.
Her her
have
little
fun.
Thrill.
But what
thrill.
I want to point out to H.
Go over.
What
and drop off
out,
dick.
Just like that.
Drop that dick off.
What's
drop
that?
Off dick.
What I want to point out to Horace
okay.
is that she didn't say anything about
Horace.
Leaving
Horace Grant.
Husband. Horace now?
She didn't say anything in that letter about leaving the husband. All she said was she wanted to feel good.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't say anything about
it's a thrill.
So you gotta listen to what she's saying, man. Listen, and a woman who's writing, she's really telling you her real feelings.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't say nothing about leaving.
Right.
She said, I want to feel good.
She just
want
a little,
feel good.
A little
take
bit,
that,
a little taste.
Yeah.
And you better keep it professional after we finish fucking.
Yes. And yes. That's really what it is.
That's real.
Keep the work.
Don't be going to Alvin's talking about, yeah.
Yeah,
I hate that.
No, but she probably will get in her feelings if she see him flirting with somebody else.
That's on her.
Quit it. She can't say nothing. It's as long as you don't do anything in the workplace that can be deemed sexual harassment.
Right.
Keep it moving.
Touche.
Hopefully she's the manager.
Delete, deny. Mm. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be putting. Okay. You know, I betrayed my people. My people being women.
Yeah, he'll just keep it cordial.
Stop giving this man names.
Hey.
I don't need him to be real.
To the both of y'all.
Harpo. What you do,
Harpo?
Harpo. Harpo, man. Look, hit it and quit it. It ain't nothing. Harpo, nothing. You. I, Herman. So you make sure.
Harpo.
That now I have a completely different perspective.
You make sure.
Wait a minute.
If it's Harpo.
You know the mayor.
He said Herman.
It's his name, right?
You said H. You said H. It's H, man. You, I'm sorry, H. You gave us H-Town.
Right.
H-Town, yes, love.
Somebody rocking, knocking the boots.
Hey. All right. Hey, H, again, have fun.
Have fun.
Have fun, man. Yeah. She's setting up a weekend. She sent you pictures. Mm. Do what you need to do.
Right.
To break her heart.
And screw who you need to screw in the workplace to move up. How about that?
She might have a position field, huh?
You feel me?
Can I feel your position, baby? Can I feel it? Never mind.
She's probably working payroll.
Put an extra $100 on that thing for you, boy.
Like that.
She's not counting.
Thank you, H, for that Truck Fest.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you.
Make sure you guys continue to send us those Truck Fests. Truckcast2018@gmail.com. Mm. Holly Heat, since you talk about sports so much,
mm-hmm.
And I know everybody has been grieving about Kobe, and yeah. I don't know if you want to talk about that, but go ahead.
With the, such a tragedy of Kobe Bryant, we're going to get a little somber for a moment. You know, it was a very tragic situation what happened to Kobe, but we see how the outpouring and love that he got.
Yeah, definitely.
And we also want to send our condolences to the kids and the family, the brothers and sisters, mom and dad, his entire family.
Definitely.
Even the other seven that were lost in that tragic crash as well.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, do you guys remember that first moment when you got the news? Because me, I remember I was coming home from the grocery store,
yeah.
and I was planning on watching the Pro Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
And my co-host in a text message was like, "Yo, DB, is this true? I'm hearing about Kobe." I'm like, "We don't really watch sports on them. Sunday, he was watching his movies, you know,
Real Housewives,
and he randomly texted me about Kobe. So
yeah.
I was like, "What you hearing?" And everybody started going off in a group chat, like, no, it ain't real. It's fake. Mm-hmm. So I started doing my research, and when TMZ reported, you know, TMZ got, they. I don't think they don't falsify much or nothing.
Right. Even though people try to hate on them?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I fuck with TMZ.
They're very credible, as you want to say. They're credible.
They are.
And I seen with TMZ, I was like, wow, after such a great night before when LeBron mm-hmm. just passed him, and he tweeted the man, and they mm-hmm. were, it's like you would think something so tragic, like, mm-hmm. I can remember me becoming like, I was dumbfounded, almost confused.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, do you kind of remember your feelings at that time?
Only thing I hate about TMZ, I'm sorry, cut you off.
Yeah, you did.
The only thing I hate about TMZ is that they attached a name to it. So that was the only thing. But
they killed Rick Fox.
Well, you know what I'm saying?
Well,
go ahead.
I don't think they reported that part, but I did hear the Rick Fox part. But they supposedly did report it prior to Kobe's wife being notified.
That's how she found out.
Right. Mm-hmm. So, and there was somebody that came out, I don't know what entity came out and said that they kind of condemned TMZ basically for reporting it before. Yeah. You know, the families had gotten a chance to find out, which is really messed up.
Yeah.
But I mean, I was at home with my daughter. I mean, she's over playing a computer game,
mm-hmm.
and I'm watching TV. And I actually, one of my followers sent it to me,
mm-hmm.
and I immediately am like, this is bullshit. And then I always, when somebody sends me something that's like super questionable, especially as it pertains to sports, I always like go straight to Google and type in whatever, so get I can see facts. Whatever tweets or articles are coming up on it, because so much, you know, we get so much information like immediately these days.
Definitely.
So and when I saw it was on TMZ, which is credible,
right?
Even though, you know.
Even though it's TMZ.
Yeah, even though it's TMZ. They are pretty credible.
But they're credible, though.
And then it was other outlets, though, in addition. Like, I still waited on CNN, because everybody like is like, oh, I'm still going to wait on CNN. There. And like, I went to CNN, and I'm like, they reported a helicopter crash. And at the same time, you're like, okay, they didn't say a name. But at the same time, you're like, they may not report a private helicopter crash like that.
Right.
Unless it has to do with somebody that has like a big name. So I pretty much knew, and I just immediately, like, my heart sunk. And I'm looking at my daughter who plays basketball, and I'm thinking, like, he was probably on a helicopter, because his daughter, his middle daughter was always, one of his middle daughters was always with him when we saw our games and things. And so it just immediately like resonated with me, like, oh my God, he was probably with the star. And then it's Kobe Bryant, like,
definitely, it's Kobe.
Like, my heart sunk. My heart sunk. I started crying immediately. Like, my daughter was like, "Mommy, what's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong?" We're very close, and I couldn't even articulate it at the time.
My initial action was why. You know, I just couldn't understand why. And then after that, my initial action after that was, it's like, what was the feeling of him being with his daughter at the time that was happening, and how close they had to hold on to each other, you know, in that time of going down, you know, like, that's a scary moment. That's a love. You know, look, she looks at her father as like
her hero,
you know, and at this moment, there's a time that he is really out of control. Right. He can't control this. Control, right. You know, everything is beyond his control, and so you just have to cling on to each other. So, my heart really went out to, you know, the families that were on that plane and how they had to look to each other, and hoping that they could, you know, survive it.
Definitely.
But then, you know, it was tragic and what happened. You know, so I was definitely heartbroken. And,
you definitely won't forget about the other victims, but you know, it is what I want to say, like, glorified, excuse me, because of Kobe and Gigi.
Right, yeah.
Because
of
that. But you know, it's other families as well. It's all tragic. But you know, I want to give a shout out to his wife. Because think about this, even in her grief of losing a 13-year-old daughter and somebody that is the stone of your family, which is Kobe, he's everything. She still had the presence of mind, the ability, the strength, the thought process to think about the others and begin to help them through their time. Yeah. And I hear people say, well, no, but these families were wealthy. It does not matter.
No.
It does not matter.
You can't put a price on people's lives.
As
much as you can do, if you at all feel responsible, which I can only assume that she feels responsible, because they were going to Kobe's Academy on probably helicopter he commissioned
thousands of times.
Which, I mean, he flew on helicopters like in his career, like, because you know, LA traffic is horrible. Like, we've been knowing
he does it
that
all the time.
But I do commend Vinette. Like, I couldn't imagine losing a child and then like your husband, of course.
Another
like,
note, not to get away, but I know we have conspiracies and things like that, but Kobe flies on that helicopter so many times.
Didn't think nothing of it.
And he is a father who loves his children, and he's a leader in the community. Right. And I just don't understand. I don't understand how that could happen. Right. I just don't understand how that could happen. So I feel like this is just my opinion. Yeah. I just feel like something might not be too right with it. I don't know. Because I just feel like he does this all the time. Well, you know how many other people fly helicopters?
Well, what happened at that moment when I was reading the backstory, that it was during a fog.
It was during fog,
And, you know, the guy circled around 15 times, you know, trying to let the fog and figure out where to land. Because mm-hmm. they were, I guess, before I was surrounded by fog, and they didn't have the devices that actually can get them where they need to be. So they were just doing it by an iPad.
See, I just feel like yeah. you got this much money.
Right.
You have the devices.
Yeah.
We fish, right. and we can fish underwater, and we can yeah. see all the rots mm-hmm. and how deep the fishes right, are. Right, right, right. And we can see mountains in front of us.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So we can understand that, you know. So mm-hmm. I don't know. That's just, you know, right. sometimes I feel like certain powers want to take our leaders away, you know. That,
I can believe that. That makes sense.
But even in death, there's a lesson.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Looking at all the pro athletes and people that's like, yo, man, hug your family.
Mm. Yeah, definitely.
You know, look at that. That's a lesson learned. Mm-hmm. Look at how the world stopped. Not maybe not the world, but basketball mm-hmm. world. Yeah. Basketball world is going to be okay. You know, look at this may make Vanessa stronger. She may turn out to save 5 important lives that may change the world. You never know.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Just, it's a reason why these things happen. I don't want to say that. I don't want to make a... You know, excuse me. You know, but at the end of the day, man, you have to find some positivity within the negative.
Yeah.
So
definitely. There it is.
I agree. We all came together in a special way. Really?
Yeah, I think everybody did.
Yeah.
I seen like basketball players reaching out to old beefs, you know.
Right. Kendrick Perkins came out.
And some other people. Paul Pierce did.
And Shaq with his beef. Yeah. He was even.
Right. He was choked up. I seen that. I was like, wow. Yeah. I can't believe that.
I mean, it seems because
they had beef.
Yeah, I mean they kind of reconciled before the end.
But
at the same, it like to see people's genuine like emotion behind it. Like
which
you
we
really
hide
know
so much.
Right. Yeah, and like I couldn't say I was a Kobe. I became a Kobe fan when he became like the enemy to everybody because I'm like an underdog person. I don't know if you could ever really call Kobe an underdog, but you know I became like when everyone was. I remember sitting in Toyota Center after the Colorado stuff and like everybody was booing him and I was just like, are you serious? Like this guy is my philosophy on sports and being a fan is different than a lot of people, but it was just
this is crazy
that these people are booing him, and I immediately was like, he really persevered through all of that. So I mean, regardless if you liked him or hated him, like you can't despite his work ethic and his drive and all of that and his contributions to the game in general.
That's it. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about right there. Good, rest in peace to Kobe. Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah.
R.I.P. Kobe, Gigi, Kobe. The 7 others that we lost.
Yeah, I mean, I've cried. I've cried so many tears over
Kobe.
Him and Gigi, man. It's ridiculous, man.
It's been a rough
ass week. 2020 is not starting off good. 2020 got to fucking improve. Like,
2020 for January since
right.
This for is five like years.
This is like this the 8th month of January.
January the 75th.
January seemed like it's been long, right?
Yeah, man.
Yes, man.
Oh my god.
What I want everybody
let's get
to
on
do.
To this bullshit ass Valentine's Day and shit like that. Now.
Let's get it over with.
Oh, because you single, folk ain't got nobody to love on.
Now I gotta get to Valentine's Day. Whoop de doo.
Right.
I gotta buy a bunch
you let
of
me bring your chocolate and your heat, Holly.
What? Yo.
I'm making them type of references all night.
You need to go talk to Hill, Herman.
You know,
and Harpo.
And fix all that, man.
Right. Oh, we're so lucky.
Oh, man.
Hey, man. You guys ready to talk that relationship talk?
Let's talk that.
I like to start off with a true or false question.
True or false?
All right, here we go. It's good to know someone's background. Of why they broke up. True or false?
True.
Hell fuck.
True. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's good to know somebody's.
True or false? It's good to know someone's background.
True or false out there, yeah. All one of y'all.
It's good to know someone's background of why they broke up. Why? Right? You think so? You think it's true?
Yeah. I would say true. But I mean, you don't want to get too deep into that because...
Well, I mean, you do want, like, if you really like the person, you do want to know, like, fine and love, but why?
But since you asked that, like,
your history is bound to repeat itself.
Okay, here
we go. Ooh, I like that.
Who said that? Malcolm X?
Dropping jewels. Black History Month.
I hope I didn't just say
that. Tito Jackson said that.
Let me at least be able to quote it if it is.
Hey, but that makes sense, though.
It makes sense, right?
Yeah.
If you don't know your history, you're bound, or it's bound to repeat itself. Yeah.
Right.
I think it actually helped you too, because if you know why, the other person, at least you can know, like, okay, well, if that's the case, let's try to talk about that before, if I really like you, let's try to talk about that before we get into the real deep.
Mitigate those kind of circumstances. Let's try to figure this out.
You know what I'm saying? So we can kind of pass that. And then
or you could just say, I ain't fucking with that. And
Or you could just peace.
Oh, peace. This peace out.
See, I like your optimism, though, man. I like it, man.
You know?
Let's see if we can work it out.
If you really like, let's see if
Holly, get your hot ass on. But no, for real, like, if you willing to work that out, but I don't know, though. Because, you know, a lot of abusive relationships. When you talk to women, like, they've been abused some kind of way.
There's like so many women being in abusive relationships, and, man.
When you
niggas stop hitting women.
When you find out their backstory, like,
it's kinda,
of course, it's different.
It could be mental, emotional,
all that.
Well, she not the ones I know. They and I got a two piece in the biscuit. Like, no, that's not cool. Like, that's not cool, bro. Like, you can't hit a woman, dog. You was a coward.
That makes sense.
You was the definition of a coward.
Super ugly.
Yeah. That's it. So it's true. So I think we definitely need to ask that question. Definitely need to ask that question, yo. All right, let's keep it going.
True.
True?
Yeah, she might be a hoe.
True.
You know?
Maybe she was just living her best life.
You know, and you want to know that.
Whoever threw that paper, like, your mama's a hoe.
I would like to know that you was out there and just going in, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know, but I wouldn't want to... Give me pieces of that. Like,
hoes
just don't throw
everybody.
Like, because they are. And, like, when I look at you...
How do you got that one friend that's a hoe?
What? Oh, hold on.
Oh, yeah,
more?
First of all, the term hoe is relative.
Okay. Oh.
So, most women won't admit being sexually liberal, which...
I don't see nothing wrong with that.
I mean, if you think about it, like, say you see a normal girl on Facebook or Instagram, and she dates, you know, four guys in a year.
Right.
So she probably fucked four guys in a year.
What is dating?
Is that,
I think dating is.
Ooh.
I don't feel like you have to fuck to date, but think a lot
but
of
you
people
can't.
Do.
So you can date and just have, and dating is like multiple people.
Yeah, you date multiple people.
I'm
dating.
I'm active in these
streets. I'm active. That's what I'm doing. I'm dating.
Active, right.
Yeah. And I'm active.
So, I mean, like, I don't think it's like, you know, people say this whole thing, but if you really look at people, even men, because...
Men
are
hoes?
You know what? I'm not. You know what?
All I know.
Woo, all I know. I'm just saying.
Okay. You know, so, but listen at what you're saying, Holly.
But you're
breaking it down to, like, what is it, sexual liberation, all that stuff.
Yeah, no, I think it's but that women are sexually liberate. Now, how everybody deals with it, I don't think you have to be, like, pick your own level of wholeness.
Right.
Okay. But all I'm saying is that, like, women dating, technically, you probably have dated... I mean, a lot of women have dated multiple guys in a year.
Right.
Now, if you add up the numbers over the year, and if you told a dude, like, okay, if I dated four guys a year for the past 10 years...
You automatically think that you fucked
everybody that you talked about.
So if I say I've dated four guys a year for the past 10 years, you're like, 40 dudes?
I dated two guys.
40?
We know we got to multiply that by times.
Yes,
three.
Well, yes.
So, okay, and then multiply at least. Yeah, okay.
Right.
So,
I only fucked four guys. Got to multiply.
Right.
You know what? You fucked eight, so.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, that's stupid. Because you omit him, don't mean you didn't fuck him.
I mean.
It's because he stroked two times.